Hi everyone, Dennis Cortez here. I'm a designer who codes, teaches, and makes music. In today's video, I'm going to be going over how I do masking in Figma. Masking in Figma is pretty simple, but you can actually use it a couple different ways to get some pretty advanced techniques and to make some really cool stuff. Whether it be for UI design and product design, print design and posters, or even marketing material and whatnot, there's a lot of ways that you can do that. I'm gonna go over the simplest way to do it in my opinion. So I have a couple examples that we're gonna go over and we'll get right into it. So going over to Figma, as you can see on the left, I have a couple pre-made ones that I made before this video so that I could show you some examples. So we're gonna be remaking these on the right side. I've set up some of the basic structure, but we're gonna go ahead and focus in on this part and make a couple examples for you. So this first one, we're gonna use UI as an example. So say you're making a profile and you need to make like an avatar and a background for the UI. This is how I would do that. So you have your circle here for your avatar and your cover. I have a couple pictures here that I'm just gonna use for examples. So I'm gonna use myself because why not? So I would go ahead and drag that in here. Put it on top of the avatar. And all you have to do is you can select both of the pieces that you want to be masked. And it's gonna use that bottom layer as the mask. You have this ellipse named avatar, and I'm gonna go ahead and click this use as mask up in the top. And as you can see, it creates a mask group. We have the photo kind of clipped and masked to the avatar and just kind of edit this image. So obviously I wanted to make it smaller. I want to make it fit within this frame. So I can go ahead and resize it and change it. I can change some of the image properties and I can go ahead and even change the fill or add others. Go ahead and add the cover in the same way. So I'm going to use this picture in my office. We're going to have it here. I'm going to drag it into here and I'm going to make sure that it's in the right frame. So I'm gonna make sure I have the cover selected because that's what I've named it for this UI. I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing. We're gonna select both the background and the cover. We're gonna go up here, click mask, and immediately it gets masked to the shape that was on the bottom layer. So I'm gonna go ahead and move this, resize it in, kind of get it fitting right. And there we go. That's how we do that for UI. Next, we're going to go ahead and make this gradient. So this would be cool for something like a poster or some sort of graphic on a website that you're trying to make. So I have this gradient. I just got it off of Unsplash. I'm going to do the same thing. Just drag it in here. I have this big A that I want it to be masked to. So again, I'm just going to select both of them. Going to come up here to this mask icon, press mask. And then now I can go ahead and play around with how I want this gradient to look. So say you want to resize it a little bit, you can even rotate it. And then what's cool about this is actually if you get more advanced with masks, you can use this with smart animate and prototyping. So I could actually make this gradient move if I wanted to, for example. For this final example, I'm gonna do something a little bit more complicated. So we're actually gonna mask this to the specific vector graphic that I have. I'm gonna go ahead and use this pre-made grid that I had. So it's literally just a bunch of squares that are put together at the same distance from each other. And we're gonna go ahead and make this grid. So I'm gonna want to make the graph vector first. So let's go ahead and just kind of map it out here. It doesn't have to be perfect for this example, but let's say we want kind of an upward trend. So we're gonna do this with our vector tool. And then it's important to note that you want to have a closed shape if you're gonna do any masking, or else you're gonna run into some issues with it. So we're gonna go ahead and close the shape on the outside. And for this stroke, I'm gonna want it to be like a neon green like we have in our example. So let's go up here. And then let's increase the stroke by a couple so we can see it better. So now that we've created our vector, let's go ahead and drag it into the frame. Make sure we get the styling correctly and let's put it towards the back so that it gets underneath of this pattern. And now I'm gonna go ahead and grab this grid, make sure it's covering everywhere that I want it to be inserted into. And then because I want to keep this stroke, I'm actually going to make a copy of this. So you can just Command D. And then I'm gonna select both of the layers that I want to use as a mask. So the first one I'm gonna choose is the graph that we made. And then secondly is the grid. It's important to note that it's gonna mask to the fill that you have. So whether it's a fill or a stroke, it's gonna mask it to that. So for this example, we actually want to remove the stroke from the one that we're gonna use as the mask, and we're gonna add a fill to it. Once that's done, we're gonna select both of these. And then as we've been doing, we're gonna go ahead and select use as mask, or we can do the keyboard shortcuts. And then that's just gonna mask it. So we have this mask group that's created, and now you can see it's fit to that shape. And we can just drag this below so that it's not overlaying over the stroke. And then that's it. So now we have that there. We can play around with the mask group if we wanna lower the opacity to make it not as obvious. And as you can see, super easy to do masks. So these are just some simple examples, but you can get really complex with these if you add a couple layers within them, and you can use your masking groups pretty creatively. So like I was saying with the Smart Animate, you can do a lot with that. So that's my quick breakdown on masking and how I approach it. Just a reminder that I do have a Patreon. So if you want to get videos early and get exclusive posts like behind the scenes and music that I'm working on that I haven't released, feel free to follow on there. It's patreon.com/shyboytm, and as always, I have a link in the description. I also make music, so if you like having music on in the background, the music that I make is really good for that, so feel free to check it out as well. It's on my YouTube channel, and you can also find some more on streaming services at cortez.us/music. That's gonna be it for this video. Let me know if you have any requests for other videos or tutorials that I can make for you, or if you have any questions about this one, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye.